blessings on dear Father Bosco and all the staff who work with him, the teaching staff, the non-teaching staff, and all the wonderful students, and you saw them performing here before you, and maybe there are more items coming, all of them who did their wonderful part. Thank you very much, the teachers who helped them, and all the support that they have received. All of us, we move forth and move forward with faith, hope, and trust in the Lord. It is God who will lead us, strengthen us, and show us the way. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Expression. We present a feast of locking and popping in this mesmerizing performance. Prepared specially by the students of class 12, this creatively engineered dance is sure to enthrall each one present here. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, I request our principal, Reverend Father John Bosco, to come up and say a few words.
Good afternoon, everyone. As I stand here today, I feel the surge of emotions within. I strongly believe that we do not choose our parts in life. Our duty is confined to playing those parts well. Today, I feel honored as I join the celebrations and offer my gratitude to God the Almighty, who by His will chose me to serve Him. I want to glorify God with a heart full of gratitude for all that He has done. My heart is filled with emotions as I stand here in retrospection of the moment when I responded to the call of God to will what God doth will, to believe that is best what God sends, is the virtue of life. I have submitted to God's will and He has kept me in the palm of His hands, and I thank Him. And on this day, as I thank God for this gift of the vocation to be a priest, for choosing me to work in this part of the diocese for which Father Angelus, my cousin, was an instrumental. And today, for giving me the grace to stand up here after 25 years of my priesthood, and some of those people who are with me on the 25 years are present here, I really feel grateful and thank God for this gift. I want very specially thank our bishop for being here with us today. He was already listed, he had listed a meeting today, an important meeting, the diocese, the Senate meeting. And the last moment when he was told that this Jubilee celebration is fixed for the 3rd May, one of the priests told me, immediately he said, "We'll postpone this meeting. I want to go for this Jubilee celebration." And I know he is counting time. He has to go rush back to Chandigarh. And that's for most of the priests here to begin the recollection at 6 o'clock. In spite of all that, my Lord Bishop, you have come here. I'm really grateful for taking out time and being with me and with all of us on this day. Thank you very much. I want to thank Father Thomas, the Vicar General of our diocese, for having come here to be part of this celebration. I want to thank Father Sahayaraj, who preached a meaningful homily, and I accept all that you said, and I try to live up to the expectation as a priest, as a servant, as service, and the three meanings that you gave, the theological meaning, the pastoral meaning, and the sociological meaning. I'll try to keep up this, and please, I request all of you to pray for me that I try to achieve this, as this is what is an expectation of a priest. And Father clearly spelled out this various dimensions. Thank you very much. I want to thank the choir members, the small students of our school, who beautifully, melodiously sang the hymns and led every one of us a prayerful atmosphere. I want to thank all the priests who have come. Most of the priests are with me, and I know them for the last 25 years. With some of them, I have celebrated silver jubilee of our relationship and friendship. And they're all here because they chose to be with me today. And I thank you for being with me today and share this joy and happiness. Thank you, fathers, for being here. I want to thank all the sisters who have come from nearby and faraway places. I know this one sister who has come, it was very difficult for her to come. She didn't have a companion. She had asked me to tell someone to come with her. She has taken trouble. Thank you all, dear sisters. In spite of it being the working day, and many of your principals and teaching in the college and principal in schools, still you have made it. Thank you very much for being here. I want to thank some good friends who have come. His Lordship has already mentioned about the couple who had come. They were there for my ordination at my place, Mr. and Mrs. Dikuna, and our relationship began when their daughter was 1.5 years old. I fell in love with her, but now she's married on 2nd of January this year. I went for the marriage. They are here with me to share this. And this deep relationship, we've been cherishing it for the last so many years. I want to thank other friends who have come from faraway places, from different places. People with whom I've worked, some of them have come here, different parishes, schools. I want to thank them very specially. I want to thank my relatives, my cousin who has come from Nangal. She and along with Father Angelus are the only relations actually as such, but all of you are related otherwise. So thank you very much for being with us. I want to thank the friends from Shimla and Solan. Some of your parents, some of your well-wishers, some of your ex-students of the school and closely associated. And your presence and your support has always encouraged me and for the development of our institution. Today, you have shown by being with me especially. I want to thank you for your support and strength. Thank you very much for coming here. I would like to thank our own students. And, you know, they have taken a lot of interest in this preparation. And right from the junior ones to the senior most students, the last dance was put up by the class 12 boys. Some of them learned by themselves, others the teachers have taught them. But they have really taken pain preparing instead of their studies. I want to thank them very specially for today being a holiday.